Hi everyone, I hope you're doing well. Today we're checking out a way to add a crease or a receding edge into a surface in Rhino. So this is how it will look. You can think of any organic shape that you might have on an automotive surface or on a product, and you might want to have a fading edge into a surface. So let's see how we do that. I'm getting rid of the environment map so you can see how the setup looks. And also I'm going to shaded mode. So this is our surface. And I'm gonna delete everything and start new. Let's go into the front view and start a new curve. So I'm going to control point curve. Let's see the center and let's draw a control point curve with 3 control points. Right click to confirm. And then I'm going to extrude that curve outward. So go to surface tools and then extrude straight. So just to create a sample surface here. Next, what I'm going to do is change the degrees of that surface. So right now we only have 4 control points. You can check them out when we click on show points. So we only have these 2 control points in the U or V direction here. And we can change the degree of the surface. So click the surface, then go here, change surface degree. And currently we have 2 U degrees. We're gonna change that to 3. And also we have 1 V degree, so change that also to 3. And then enter. So now we have a lot more points we can work with. From the top, I'm going to select a few down here, this row of points. And then I'm going to turn them a little bit, move them around, and then also maybe push them down. So we have a really, really organic surface here. And we can do the same thing with the second row, maybe push them down a little bit so we can get a good starting surface. So press escape and then right click to rendered mode. So this is our surface that we work with. And back to shaded mode, I'm going to create a new curve that informs the second part of that edge. So we want to have a crease here that slowly fades into the original surface. For that, I'm going to the curve tools and then quickly select a straight single line. And then go from the endpoint here somewhere where you want to have the edge start. So click again. This is our new surface edge for the second surface. You could cut the original surface with a pre-made curve. What I'm going to do is right click onto split, and that splits the surface with an iso curve. So right click on split, and then you can see you have a preview of how the cut will look like. If you toggle here in the command bar, it will toggle between U and V direction. So T, enter, and it will toggle. So now I can go to that corner and the end of the curve that we just drew and split that surface into 2. Next, I'm going to also split the upper surface into 2. So right click again to select the split tool, and then I'm pressing T to toggle into the U direction. And that basically informs when our crease or the transitions should start. So just around here. And now we can get rid of this surface. We don't need that anymore. So let us create this new missing surface here. I'm going to double click the perspective view so you can see it better. Let's go to surface tools, and right now I can use a loft. So go to loft and then loft these 2 curves, and we don't need to change anything here. Just click OK. So right now that looks pretty bad, but let's change that quickly. We can go into the surface tools. We can go up here to match surface, and that's a really powerful tool. I'm going to match that newly created surface with the edge of that original surface over here. So right now with match surface, we will click the curvature continuity button here and then press OK. And that basically ensures that this transition here will be perfect. So there's no visible line or anything. We can check that also by going up here to the curvature analysis. I love the environment map option. So you press environment map and that just gives you a nice reflective material so you can check the surface quality. So as you can see, it looks like it's one surface. It doesn't have any weird reflections going on. It's pretty perfect. So we'll close that again. And now we have to match this new edge. As you can see, it's not really matching with that lower surface yet. We have to match the new edge to the old one. So again, I'm using the match surface tool. Go up here. And then now I'm going to click the new edge and then the original one. So here you can see I accidentally pressed on the wrong side of the edge. So let me do that again, match surface, and then try to select it on the ends. So I'll select here and here. And now we only need position continuity. So we're gonna make sure that the edge with the old edge, but it doesn't need to have a curvature transition. What's important now, it's moving all the edge points and aligns them with the whole edge. What I'm going to click is match edges by closest points. So that ensures that the current transition doesn't get messed up. So press OK. And now we can preview the reflection here with our new surface. Let's go to the surface analysis and then environment map. And now you can see this really subtle but nice edge transition here. So it's a receding edge, it has a fade, and you will be able to see that in the final product. So that was it for this tutorial. I hope you learned something new today. If you did, then be sure to hit the subscribe button and click the notification bell icon so you will be notified whenever I upload a new video. Thanks for now, and I will see you soon. Bye bye.